The COSO framework, we'll see COSO framework, internal controls, and we will discuss ERM. These two are very important concepts because as after 2002, internal control has become mandatory for the firm. So everyone need to make an internal audit department. And in internal audit department, you have to put COSO framework. You have to adopt a COSO framework and ERM. What are those? I will explain shortly. What is internal control? So there is a definition of internal control. It's a system devised by board of directors, management and other personnel designed to provide reasonable assurance regarding the objective related to operation, reporting and compliance. So we want to focus on the processes. We want to make these are flawless, they are efficient, they are more faster, and it add value in day-to-day operations. So he says that it's internal audit is internal control is an ongoing process. You cannot say that we achieved to our level. Every day there is a new scenario affected by all people. Also provide reasonable assurance, not absolute assurance. So means having internal audit department in a company does not mean that you have no issues. You may have issues, so it can give you a reasonable assurance, not the absolute assurance. Hardwork says it has objectives. First they have operational objective, then the reporting objective, right? Operational objective means, you know, what is operation? When we open the door of the office and the close it in the night, everything, sale, purchase, procurement, hiring, firing, this is day-to-day operational matter. So we want to protect our assets, we want to put policies, procedure, you know, so they can deliver us the most effective workflow. Reporting objective means our system should be capable to generate financial and non-financial reports. They should be reliable, efficient, and it can help users to take effective decision. Yeah, he says internal financial reporting objectives may be division level. Internal objectives may relate to customer satisfaction. External financial reporting objective may be interim financial statements. COSO frameworks, external financial reporting objective may be internal control reports. So there could be several objectives for that. We have compliance objective, means that whatever applicable rules, regulation and laws, internal control department should make sure that we are into that accordance. Even nowadays, environmental law, anti-money law, then anti-terrorism law and other laws, health safety laws, EHS, health safety and environment, these all has to be taken in consideration. So in short, he said these are the objectives. So operation, reporting and compliance. Sometime objective can have a overlap, so we have to study how to handle them. Sub objectives means that there is a broader objective and there are inner objective for each departments. So moving forward, now we will discuss the component of the internal control. So internal control has, you cannot achieve internal control if you don't focus on these components. You have to deploy these components, then internal control will be achieved. I will tell you broadly, if I want to bring something in the company, first I have to tell everyone the importance of that. Right, so that is called control environment. Means I have to build up the atmosphere, environment that we are, we internal controls are really effective, useful, so take it positively. Management should be committed, there should be an integrity of the management, there should be a proper organizational structure, human resource policies, procedures. That will be the strong part of the internal control, which lies under control environment. So first we have environment, then we have to know that what we want to control, that is a control activity. Then we have to see that what, once we define what to control, then we gather information and we see how people communicate with each other. Then of course we start monitoring, because without monitoring there is no gain of having systems. So this is what he says: control environment, risk assessment, how to assess the risk, what you want to control, how information passes, and the monitoring is the very important. So one by one he will explain what is control environment. I told you management integrity, ethical values, communication, it attitude towards integrity and ethical value. Because if the management is not ethical, then any system will not produce any kind of quality in the organization. Then of course we have to make sure that management is independent from the control. Like there should be head of internal audit which will be reporting to audit committee. Management is putting the system, so this reporting lines you have to make it very clear. Risk assessment, that your system should have ability to assess the risk. So there should be some objective, strategy, priorities, how to handle risk management you have to use. Operational objective should define that what is your risk tolerance. Tolerance means that what you can absorb, what is your risk appetite, ability to bear the risk. For example, if you are a bank, market is down and you cannot absorb the default risk, so you will stop lending. But there might be a big bank still in the recession, they can lend because they feel that they are big and their risk ability to absorb the risk is bigger. External reporting objective, that we should consider materiality, reflect entity activities. External non-financial reporting objectives, as I explained. Internal reporting objective, and then we have compliance objectives. So these all objectives we have to keep in our mind once we are planning for objectives. It says organization identify all risk, internal or external. And then they say what is the objectives, and they analyze risk, how to determine, how to handle, how to prioritize. So that's lead to a risk management in general. Yeah, risk tolerance I explained you already. And risk responses, consider how each risk will be managed. So we have some specific risk responses. For example, if there is a recession, I can stop lending. So this is risk avoidance. I can share the risk. That is, for example, insurance company, when they insure a ship, sea ship, if they insure alone, so that can be a disaster. So what they do is they combine 4 or 5 insurance companies, they share insurance 20%, 30% this way, so yeah, of the ship. So that is risk sharing. So these are certain risk responses that we can have. And what are your preventive controls, detectives, segregation of duties, how you handle these things? These are important to understand, right? Who approves the transaction, who record it, who authorize, who reconcile? These are the things that you should work on in order to handle a better control activity. Segregation of duty means divide the work into different people. Suppose if I am the one who issue receipt, I am the one who will write in the system, I am the one who go to deposit and next day I do reconciliation. So that will be a worse system because we have to segregate the work, divide the work into different people. Because 1% fraud, we can catch, right, by putting systems. But lot of people, if they are involved in the process, there are more likely chances that we will get a better value out of the process. So we should put general controls, and we should see that how we inform and communicate between each other. And we should know information should be relevant, it should have quality, it should be timely, it should add value to the users this way. These are some important informations.